Today I'm going to show you how I made this cutting board on the CNC machine. We do have plans available for it on our website, so be sure to check that link in the description so that you can make it for yourself.
It's time to get started on a new project. We're going to be making a cherry cutting board and need to get it held down on the CNC. For that, I'm using the vacuum table on the Spektra M1000 CNC machine, and you can see that it sucks down that board really well and it's going absolutely nowhere. So the Spektra has a pneumatic dust boot on it, so it lowers and rides on the surface of the material. So no matter how long your bit is, it's going to get maximum suction in that area. I'm using the RC-2265 three-wing insert carbide flattening bit to go through here and flatten off the top surface. We do have the plans for this available on our website, so be sure to check that out. It does have lessons that will apply to other projects as well throughout the instructions included in the plans. So we did the exact same thing on the back side after getting it flipped over, and we can pick up the 45624-K 60 degree Spektra coated V bit. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe to our channel and go ahead and hit that bell so that you'll be notified on all of the new videos when they're released. Also, don't forget to follow us on Instagram at ToolsToday. And for this, we're going to carve in some text on this cutting board. So we're just going to go through here, and it did a really nice job. I left a little bit of fuzzies on some of these edges, as this is the absolute worst case scenario for this bit, cutting cross grain on cherry, but it did a really nice job. There's zero chip out or anything like that, so it was super simple to clean up and get ready for some epoxy. But overall, it did a really nice job with this text. So we got that all done, and you can see those fuzzies that I was talking about right there. But like I said, it's very minimal. So we got it pulled off the CNC over to the workbench, and with like 15 seconds of sanding and 220 grit sandpaper, we have a perfectly clean carve. And I just used some Zinsser seal coat. So this is to seal up the grain for when we pour epoxy in it. That way we don't have any sort of bleeding. So I'm using some Total Boat 2-to-1 epoxy with some Black Diamond Pigments Bora Bora here, and it filled in really nicely. I love the color of this. So after that is done, we can get the tape removed that I used for the sanding sealer. I'm going to put this back on the CNC to flatten off most of the epoxy to make the sanding process easier. I'm using a piece of paper with two pieces of painter's tape on top of it to act as an offset. So that way I'm not going to cut into the wood at all. And this will give me enough height there that I can sand back down, but remove the majority of the epoxy. That way I don't create any divots or anything like that. So I set my Z height there. And then we'll get to cutting through the epoxy. It did a really nice job flattening off using the same bit that I used to flatten the entire boards. And you can see that we have some really nice shavings coming off of that epoxy. I realized that I should probably just use a single piece of tape. So I removed one, re-zeroed everything off, and then we just took another little light pass to make sure that we got all of the epoxy down nice as flush as we could without actually cutting into the wood. So that part is done. And again, like I said, you got some nice shavings there. That's exactly what you want to see from epoxy. We'll get that removed from the CNC, and then we'll take it back over to the workbench and just sand off that area. I was careful to make sure that I had sanded the entire board, not just this area in particular, so that way we don't create a divot there. So it turned out really nice. Super happy with the way that the text on the cutting board turned out. So after this is done, we'll get it put back on the CNC, and we'll use the RC-45711 90 degree V insert bit to go through and add a chamfer along the edge of this cutting board. It's really a nice way to do it on the CNC, and I can do this before I do the profile cut. So I have this set up to do a profile cut on the line, and that gives me a really nice area that I can chamfer, and then later I'll cut the profile down right up next to it, and we'll have a nice chamfer there. It did a really nice job on the end grain even, leaving perfectly clean cuts, so that was definitely really nice to see. And you can see how big the chips are, and that's exactly what you want to see. You want chips, not sawdust, when using bits like this to cut wood. So now I've got it switched out for the 45914 5/16 inch radius core box bit to go through here and do a juice groove, going through in two passes, so that way it's a little bit less stress on the bit, and we're ending on a final pass of 0.4 inches. Really like the way that this juice groove came out, and it definitely looks really nice there. So this is complete. So now one of the things that I really want to do is actually pop the grain on the CNC and use that bit to go back through to minimize the amount of sanding that I need to do. So I just pop the grain with water. That will raise the grain. I need to do this anyways for cutting boards, so it's nice to do this on the CNC. That way I can take a full pass depth. So this is cutting at the full height that we did before, and you can see it just removing some really tiny little shavings there. And that's exactly what we want. This minimizes the amount of sanding that's necessary, and I'm going to do it one more time just to be sure that we got as much grain popped as we could, as it's definitely going to speed up the sanding process considerably. So we went back through again, and again you can see those really fine shavings coming off, and on the CNC we were able to achieve a cut that needs absolutely zero sanding and doesn't need to be popped again going forward. So really happy with that, and really like the way that that turned out. So this juice groove is done, and we can move on to cutting the profile around the outside. For that, I'm going to be using the 46321-K quarter inch upcut bit. The upcut is going to evacuate chips quite a bit better, and it's going to make sure that we have a nice clean cut. I definitely should have done a final pass where I took an inside step to remove any of the lines there. I didn't realize that I didn't do that until after I had already pulled it off of the CNC, but that would be one way to avoid showing those lines there on the edge. But anyways, it turned out really nice, and I'm happy with the way that it worked. It just required a little bit of extra sanding, as any CNC machine is going to leave those lines as it's going down in multiple passes. So this is done, left a nice clean cut on the bottom edge, which is exactly what you want from an upcut bit. So we can get that removed from the CNC. You can see those lines that I was talking about right there, but it's not a huge deal because we are still going to pop the grain on everything else. So as I explained before, the water is going to pre-pop that grain, so that way when you contact the surface with water, when you're actually using the cutting board, the grain does not stand back up and you get a nice smooth finish that doesn't get affected when you actually get water on the cutting board. So after a couple swipes with 220 grit sandpaper, we have a really nice edge. I'll go back and do this again later on in the process, but I want to match the edge that I have on the front side with a chamfer the same size on the back side. So I'm using the 47306 three flute 45 degree chamfer bit to do that on the router table. So I'm just going to take a single pass here using the micro jig grip block to keep my hands away from the bit and keep things nice and safe. So we went through and did the cut along the entire backside surface to leave the matching chamfer on the front edge. Even on the end grain, we're left with really smooth cuts. With that done, I switched the M1000 vacuum table out for the vertical clamping table, and this allows me to work on the end grain on this piece. So I got everything clamped in nice and secure, and then leveled each side out using just a 90 degree square to make sure that I had it perfectly level with the table. This is a really unique feature on this CNC. Not a whole lot of CNCs are able to have vertical clamping tables, but this M1000 has a ton of different things that you can do with it. I sort of made a mistake and should have done the chamfer later and had to try to line up with my chamfered edge since I didn't have a back edge that I could easily line up with. So I used the RC-45711 90 degree V insert bit to go through here and make a couple test lines. That first one was about 1/16 of an inch off, so I had to move my Y0 position back about 1/16 of an inch. We got it perfectly centered, so now we can go pick up the core box bit. This is the same one that we used to cut the juice groove, and we can go down through here in three passes to get to the final depth. I didn't want to put a ton of stress on the vertical clamping table, so I went with smaller step downs, so that way we made sure that everything stayed nice and secure. So we're going through, like I said, in three passes to get to that final depth. And on this one, we're going to do the exact same thing that we did with the juice groove. I really like the fit of this, and it fit really nice in the hand. So we're going to go through and pop the grain on the CNC, and then we'll come back with the bit running at a full depth. I used a air compressor to dry that really quickly. That way there was a little bit less downtime. So I went with a full depth pass here again, just to remove that grain that had popped up, and we're left with a groove that needs no additional sanding at all, even after popping the grain. So we'll get it removed from the CNC again. Since a lot of CNC machines are not capable of doing a vertical clamping like that, here's another way to do the finger holds on a router table. We will have a full build video on this jig, as well as the plans available here shortly, but I figured it'd be cool to show it in here too. So I made this, and it has a couple stops on it that allows you to set the length that you want of the finger hold, and it has a backing that allows you to make sure that you keep it nice and square to the router table. Typically these are fairly not safe to do on a router table without some sort of jig like this. I took it in two passes and it definitely worked really well. For this I'm using the 45916 5/16 inch radius core box. The big difference between this one is that it's a half inch shank instead of a quarter inch shank like the one that I was using on the CNC. So we got that cut in there and it worked out really nice. I'll just pop the grain on that one and then do a bit of sanding in there. Using the Gator micro zip, I was able to sand over all of the sharper edges that were still left, and then I sanded the entire board down to 220 grit before applying the walrus oil. I got everything blown off and used the walrus oil cutting board oil for the finish on here. I just spread it around by hand and put a nice thick coat on there, and then I let it sit on there overnight before buffing it off the next morning. So it looks really nice, and I'm super happy with the way that the walrus oil made the grain pop. These finger holds work really well for being able to pick it up, and we have the cutting board in its final resting location. The backside of this cutting board actually has the map of the Lake of the Ozarks, which is where we're at. We will also have a full video on the backside of this cutting board as well, as it's definitely amazing. So the scenery out here is pretty awesome, and it definitely fits with the cutting board and the theme of it as well. So we're getting the first use on the cutting board and couldn't be happier with the way that the finish turned out and the way that it looks in its environment. So this one is done. Be sure to check out the plans available for making this for yourself, but hopefully you guys enjoyed this one. We will catch you guys back out here in the next one. Have a great day, everybody.
Thank you guys so much for watching. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe right over here. And for more great videos, click right over here.